There are prodigies whose talents are evident even at a preschool age. Not so in most cases, though, including Breanna Stewart. But now one can make the case that our hometown girl from Cicero, North Syracuse has become the greatest women's basketball player of all time. Eric Smith coached Breanna at CNS.
I teach in a middle school, so in middle school in fifth grade, I hadn't grown into her frame yet, so she was pretty awkward. She's still pigeon-toed. She's going to be the best player in the world.
By ninth grade, however, she made a freakish play in New York City, and the basketball world took notice.
By the time she was in 11th grade, she was dominating everything that she was playing. And then her senior year, we went to a prestigious tournament out in Phoenix, Arizona, and she was by far the best player in the tournament. You know, we're playing teams that had 7-8 Division I players.
While in our midst, Stewart was Gatorade Female Athlete of the Year, Naismith Prep Player of the Year, and a McDonald's All-American. With the USA Basketball Under-16, Under-17, and Under-19 teams, she won gold medals. She was one of only two Scholastic girls chosen at the time for a USA Pan American Games team. Call her Bree, call her Stewie, Breanna Stewart, daughter of Brian and Heather Stewart, is the most decorated female basketball player at the high school, college, and professional levels at the age of 25. Named USA Basketball Female Athlete of the Year in 2011, 13, and 18, Associated Press Player of the Year in 2014, Women's Naismith College Player of the Year in 2015, she also received a 2016 ESPY Award as the best female athlete. Stewart's high school coach heard from a who's who of college coaching.
He was probably the one coach that I never had contact with.
Connecticut's Gino Auriemma.
They kind of sell themselves.
Auriemma jokingly relates the time when Stewie had a subpar stretch of games her first year. Against Baylor, she only played 7 minutes.
One mistake after another by Stewie, I couldn't get her out fast enough.
He's grateful for her presence, though, in nearly every other game over a four-year span, as UConn won 4 consecutive NCAA titles, with Bree the Final Four MVP every year. Try to equal that standard. Also, the 6'4" star with a 71-inch wingspan was consensus Player of the Year 3 times.
And somebody shoots the ball from the right side of the floor. The ball hits the front of the rim, and it goes straight up. And Stewie comes running in, and as the ball is still at the top, above the rim, she goes up, up, and catches the ball and just kind of like flicks it in the basket. So now we go, okay, let's go, this next thing. So now the next thing, we run a pick and roll. Now normally when you say, we got a 6'4 center, she's setting the screen. In this one, because Stewie was so versatile, we could do a million different things. She was the ball handler, and we had someone else setting the ball screen. So, kid sets the screen, Stewie comes off the screen, they play it a certain way, she steps back and makes a 3.
Auriemma whistled the end of practice.
We have a guy on our team that just dunked and then made a step back 3. We're done. Ain't gonna get any better than this. And it doesn't get any better than Stewie.
Hey Stewie, it's CD, but I just wanted to say congratulations for all you've done so far, and you have so much more ahead of you. I'm happy to have been a part of it.
She went on to win Olympic gold in 2016, was the obvious first overall pick in the WNBA draft, and signed a multi-year deal with Nike before ever playing a game for the Seattle Storm. Rookie of the Year, she was also named the league and playoff finals MVP. Internationally, Breanna has starred as FIBA World Cup MVP. A ruptured Achilles tendon unfortunately occurred during the EuroLeague title game, requiring surgery and a lengthy West Coast rehab. We all look forward to her return to MVP form, but for now, Breanna Stewart becomes a member of the Greater Syracuse Sports Hall of Fame, Class of 2019.